The graph below shows the base of an object. Compute the value of the volume of the object given that cross-sections perpendicular to the base are squares. We'll determine the volume two ways. We'll first determine the volume using geometric formulas, and then we'll also determine the volume using integration using the method of volume by slices. Recall, using integration to find the volume by slices, the volume equals the integral from a to b of a of x dx, where a of x, the integrand function, is the area of any vertical cross-section. Let's first make sure we understand the three-dimensional figure. Again, every cross-section perpendicular to the base is a square, which means on the left, we have a right pyramid, and on the right, we have a right rectangular prism or a box. Let's determine the total volume first using geometric formulas. Where the volume of a pyramid equals 1/3 times the length times the width times the height, or we can say 1/3 times the area of the base times the height, and the volume of the box or right rectangular prism is length times width times height. We'll have to use both formulas. The total volume equals, for the pyramid, we have 1/3 times, notice the base, this square here, is a 6 by 6 square. And the height along the x-axis from x equals 0 to x equals 5 is 5 units. The volume of the pyramid is 1/3 times 6 times 6 times 5. And then plus the volume of the box on the right. Let's let the base be the 6 by 6 square, and notice the height is from x equals 5 to x equals 9, indicating the height is 4. The volume of the box on the right is equal to 6 times 6 times 4. Simplifying, we have 60 plus 144, which equals 204 cubic units. And now to determine the volume using integration. We'll have to set up two integrals, one for the volume of the pyramid and one for the volume of the right rectangular prism or the box. Recall the volume equals the integral from a to b of a of x dx, where a of x is the area of any vertical cross-section. Let's take a look at one vertical cross-section of the pyramid. We know it's going to be a square. Let's just say this is one vertical cross-section. Notice the dimensions of the square change from x equals 0 to x equals 5. But we already know for the integral, the limits of integration will be from 0 to 5. And now we need a function of x for the area of any of the squares from x equals 0 to x equals 5. To do this, notice the equation of this line segment is y equals 3/5 x, because the slope is 3/5 and the vertical intercept is 0. Now if we take a look at a cross-section here on the right, let's assume this is the x-axis. The length from the x-axis to the point above the x-axis, this length here, would be 3/5 x, which means the total length of one of the sides of any cross-section from here to here would be 2 times 3/5 x, so s is equal to 2 times 3/5 x, which is equal to 6/5 x, which means a of x, the area of any square that is a vertical cross-section from x equals 0 to x equals 5, would be the square of 6/5 x dx. This will give us the volume of the pyramid. And then plus, for the volume of the box on the right, the limits integration will be from x equals 5 to x equals 9. And the area of any vertical cross-section will always be the same square, any of these squares, will be a 6 by 6 square. The integrand function is simply 36. And now we determine the antiderivatives. Notice here the integrand function is really 36 divided by 25x squared, and the antiderivative is 36 divided by 25 times x cubed divided by 3, which is 36 divided by 75x cubed. And plus, the integral of 36 with respect to x is simply 36x. Next, we determine big F of 5 minus big F of 0 and then plus big F of 9 minus big F of 5, which gives us 36 divided by 75 times 5 cubed. Minus when x is 0, we have 0, and then plus 36 times 9 minus 36 times 5. Simplifying, we have 60 plus 324 minus 180, which gives us the same result of 204 cubic units. I hope you found this helpful.